And now, Riders Radio Theater presents the ongoing saga of The Cowboy Way. Tonight's episode, Meltdown on the Mesa. As faithful listeners may recall from our last chapter, it's summer, and there's drought on the old Triple X. In a desperate search for water, riders in the sky have driven their entire herd to the top of Three Mile Mesa. As the hot western sun sinks low, they settle down for the long, hot night ahead. The late afternoon is strangely quiet. Perhaps too quiet.
I don't like it, boys. It's quiet.
Perhaps too quiet.
Yep, sure don't seem right.
No, well, it ain't right. No.
You know, in this kind of condition, the smallest noise could start as... could start a... stampede!
Oh, stampede!
Let's start a stampede!
Oh,
look out! Turn them, boys!
They're heading for the cliff! Gosh! Oh, that's in the lead! Look out! It's
too late! Turn them! Turn them!
It's too late! They're going over!
Oh, no. The whole herd lost. Splattered on them rocks down there.
Some of my best friends, too.
My chuck wagon. Well, no beans tonight.
Well, that's some consolation. But this wouldn't have happened if you hadn't fired your gun, Slim.
I didn't fire my gun. You fired yours.
No, I didn't.
Ranger Doug.
You boys know better than that.
Well, sure, but who did it?
I don't know who did it, boys, but... if this wasn't an accident, it's the work of the meanest, vilest, most low-down, evil, slimy...
Howdy, boys.
Slocum, what are you doing here?
Me and Charlie were just in the neighborhood and thought we'd check out all the racket. Right, Charlie?
Right, boss. Racket.
Say, is that your herd of hamburger down there? Ooh, what a stink that's gonna be. Hey, I hope you have good insurance.
Yes, it's gonna be a stink, and yes, we do have insurance. Don't we, Ranger Doug?
Indeed we do, Slocum. We have complete saddle blanket coverage from the famed Lloyds of Lubbock.
Maybe you ought to check your policy.
That should be easy enough. I have a copy of it right here in my saddlebags.
Mind if I take a look at it?
Not at all. Right here, Slocum.
It's a Lloyds policy, all right. Let's just check your coverage here. Let's see. Good glacier protection, tidal waves, right, nuclear fallout. That's A. Other than that, everything looks... uh-oh. Better take a look at the last clause, Ranger Doug.
Okay, Slocum. I'll need a microscope to look at this.
Charlie?
Right. Here you are, Cowboy Bob.
Turn it up to 400x or so.
Let's see, stampedes,
in
the event of unruly four-footed ungulate behavior resulting in free fall of more than 2 meters, this policy is null and void. No settlements, no refunds, don't even ask.
Oh, tough break, guys.
What? Unruly educated behavior? What in tarnation does that mean, fellas?
It means we've been swindled.
Swindled? Gosh, how are we going to meet our mortgage payment next month?
And we got a balloon payment, too.
What?
Say, maybe I can help.
Well, what's that?
Just a little contract, that's all.
Right.
You sign over your rights to the old Triple X and you're out of debt. I'll even throw in a couple of $1,000 in a condo in Laredo. Talk about the easy way. Give him a pen, Charlie.
All right, Slocum.
Sounds okay to me. What do you think, Slim?
Well, it does sound pretty good, all right.
Not so fast, Slocum. We know what you're up to. You've been taking over ranches left and right all over the valley. You wrangled control of the old Tinker's Dam and cut off everybody's water. That's the main reason there's a drought all across this land.
It's my water. I guess I can do what I want with it.
Maybe so. But now you want the old Triple X so you can control the railhead and the main trail out of Tumbleweed Valley. We let our neighbors and the orphanage use it free. But you probably want to close it off like you did Tinker's Dam and ruin the rest of the valley.
Yeah, you tell him, Ranger Doug. Mouse!
Slocum, you're right. Selling out to you would be the easy way, but...
It wouldn't be the cowboy way.
Oh, something smells around here, and it ain't hamburger. Slocum, get off of my land!
Now, boss?
Easy, Charlie, not yet. Okay, we're going, but we'll be around in case anything happens to change your mind. Come on, Charlie.
Cash, right, boss. Boys... I smell something funny.
I guess you're right, Woody. I guess we'd better give the herd a decent burial.
No, no, Ranger Doug. I don't mean the herd. It's smoke.
It is smoke, Woody. And it's coming from the direction of the bunkhouse.
Oh, no.
This looks bad. Let's ride, boys.
And it was bad. Arriving back at the famed old Triple X, riders in the sky found their luxurious fleece-lined bunkhouse engulfed in flames.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Oh, no, we gotta save our valuables.
I'll get the Vaughn Monroe poster.
Too late for that. Just grab your instruments.
I'm going in to get my biscuit, though.
Don't go side, me.
No, side. Don't go back in there.
Riders in the sky struggled in a vain yet heroic effort, to save their beloved fleece-lined bunkhouse. But alas, it was not to be. And as they watched the flames leap higher and higher, they suddenly realized that their loss might be even greater than they had feared.
Oh, boy, it's lucky we all got out of there.
Nobody could survive that inferno.
I guess you're right. I guess we should just count our blessings, fellas. We're all safe, at least. Say, we all are here, aren't we? Woody?
Yo!
Slim?
I'm here.
Sidemeat?
Sidemeat!
We've got to go back for him.
We got to get him. It's too late. The roof's collapsed.
Oh, no. First the herd, then the bunkhouse, and now our faithful sidekick. Is this the end of Riders in the Sky?
Dawn is breaking, and unbeknownst to Riders in the Sky, two sinister figures creep to the edge of the rim rock that towers over the smoldering old Triple X.
Are they all there, Charlie? You got the binoculars.
One, two... What comes after two, Slocum?
Three, Charlie.
Three, right. That's all there are, boss. Say, maybe the fire got the old-timer.
Well, that's too bad. What a nice way to start the day, Charlie.
Say, think they'll sell out now?
Yeah, maybe. But let's soften them up a little more. Grab that timber over there and give me
right.
a hand.
Meanwhile, unaware of the peril lurking high above them, we find our forlorn trio kicking through the rubble of their burned-out bunkhouse, seeking hope in the ashes.
Gee, we've lost everything.
Yeah, we've lost the herd and
the luxurious fleece-lined bunkhouse.
And our beloved sidekick.
Who?
Who?
Sidemeat.
Oh.
Yeah. Hey, can I have his mule, guys? He won't need it anymore.
Would he? Oh! What is this disgusting blob? It nearly broke my toe.
Why, it's biscuit dough.
Wow, look at that stuff. It's hard as a rock.
Harder? Why, I bet it's the...
hardest substance known to man.
Gee, it's kind of like a monument to the old geezer, isn't it?
Great idea, Woody. Here, help me lift it up.
Okay. Well, it's heavy. This biscuit's talking to me.
Yeah, they always repeat it on me too, Woody.
Look, it's not solid, boys. It's like a manhole cover over this hole and what?
Well, oh, howdy, boys.
Side me.
I thought I was a goner. It was the biscuit dough what saved me.
Glad to see you back. Have some water, old timer.
Oh, thanks, Ranger Duck.
Meanwhile, high on the rim rock.
Why is this boulder so hard to move, boss?
What's going on down there? Oh, no. The geezer is still alive.
He's not a geezer, boss. He's a sidekick. Weren't you listening last week?
Thinking again, are we, Charlie?
Huh?
That's more like it.
Right. So why is this darn boulder so hard to push, huh?
If you want to start a landslide, you push the boulder down the hill, Charlie.
Right.
Always remember, the landslide goes down the hill.
Right,
we want to kill eagles, we get a slingshot, okay?
While these two evil villains labor at their foul play, Riders in the Sky and the revived sidekick Sidemeat set about clearing away the debris from last night's inferno.
Boy, this thing's heavy. Ow! Well, some of these timbers are still might hot.
You know, none of this would have happened if we'd have had my new SDI in place.
SDI? What's that, Sidemeat?
Well, it's Sidemeat's Defense Initiative.
What?
Sidemeat's Defense Initiative?
Yeah, Woody Paul, it works like this. You float a guy up in a hot air balloon, see, and he's armed with a good supply of biscuits made from this new titanium dough. That stuff's hard.
Boy, you can say that again.
That stuff's hard. He's floating around up there in space, see? And he sees somebody sneaking on the old Triple X ranch. Bingo! He zings him with one of them biscuits. Moo! The Sidewinder's out of commission. What do you think, Ranger Duck?
I don't know, Sidemeat. What do you suppose it would cost to get this outfit operational?
Well, I got her penciled in at about, $70 million.
$70 million?
Yeah.
What do you need all that money for?
Fuel.
To buy fuel?
No, it is the fuel.
Oh.
I needed $1 bills. Nothing burns like money.
You can say that again.
You gotta look at the big picture, Ranger Doug.
Uh-huh.
The sky filled with balloons.
Right.
Oh, they stay in touch with mirrors. Oh, nothing gets past them. It'll bring thousands of jobs to the valley. Oh. You gotta have 100 guys baking biscuits.
Uh-huh.
100 guys flying balloons.
Uh-huh.
100 guys...
burning money. Right.
It'll turn this valley around, I tell you.
Side, I'm not sure we can fund the entire $70 million, but perhaps we can spare a little R&D. Here's $7 for flour.
Okay, but I wouldn't hold me up too long.
Oh.
I hear Slocum and his evil empire's working on one of these.
It's not a futuristic weapon system that Slocum is working on, Sidemeat. It's the oldest one known to man.
Of course. One.
Two. And,
you remember, Charlie.
Three. Yeah, three.
We got it. Look at that rock roll. Oh, there's another one. And another one. It's a full-size landslide. Let's see how the cornball cowboys stand up to an avalanche of rock and roll.
Right, boss.
Below, our unsuspecting trio has other things on their minds.
Hey, Sidemeat, you feel up to fixing in a dinner? I'm mighty hungry, partner.
You must be Woody Paul. Your stomach's growling like a landslide.
Say, that's not Woody, Sidemeat. Look up at the rim rock.
It is a landslide.
If we can get to the horses, we can outrun it.
It's no use. We'll never make it.
We're trapped. Is this the end of Riders in the Sky?
As the dust settles, it reveals 1,000 tons of rock and boulder covering the famed old Triple X.
Come on, Charlie. Let's go down and bury any survivors.
Right, Slocum. Survivors.
Are there any survivors? To find out, we must go deep, deep, and deeper still into the craggy sandstone mass that carpets the once peaceful Triple X ranch. There in the heart of the rockfall, in a dark, cramped, hollow space, all is silent. Or is it?
Slim! Slim, is that you? Are you all right?
Yeah, Ranger. Ranger Doug, I'm okay. Is that you, Woody?
Oh, I think so.
Yeah, it's you, all right.
Thanks, Slim.
We're all here, then. Except Sidemeat.
Side!
Oh. Can you hear me? Look around for him, boys. He was right next to me when the landslide hit.
Hit is right. Hey. Everything hurts except my head.
I can understand that. Your head's always been a marvel to me.
Thanks, Slim. Well, I wonder why we weren't all pounded into pancakes.
Yeah, I guess we were sure lucky. Right, Ranger Doug?
Well, not exactly lucky too, Slim.
What do you mean, Ranger Doug?
Well, Slim, as every ranger knows, a little-known geological phenomenon occurs within a sandstone landslide in the Tumbleweed Valley. It's much like the eye of a hurricane. As this landslide approached, I did a quick radar yodel and calculated precisely where to stand.
I remember you calling all of us to your side.
Right you are, Slim. When these landslides peak, as I ascertained this one was about to, the slide epicenter forms a cramped cavern of calm, and that's where we are now. Oh!
Hey, watch where you're going, you bingo.
Sidemeat!
Of course it is. Who'd you think it was? Amelia Earhart?
We were afraid we'd lost you, old pal.
No, I've been right here the whole time. I fell on this bag of biscuits and knocked myself out. I come to a while ago, and I've just been sitting here, gathering my thoughts.
Gathering your... That probably didn't take too long.
Well, now that we're all here, let's spread out and see if we can find a way out of this.
Great idea, Ranger Doug.
Thanks, Nolan.
Meanwhile, unaware of the Riders in the Sky's heroic search for freedom, two sinister figures, stooped and crabby beneath the hot western sun, scrabble down the face of the fractured rim rock to gloat over their murderous deed.
Come on, Charlie. I want to get down there and gloat.
Yeah.
Boy, some avalanche, eh?
Boss, weren't you listening to Texas Bix? Listen, it wasn't an avalanche.
Shut up, Charlie. Shut up and scrabble.
Right, boss. Right.
Meanwhile, far below and morally miles away from these crabby crooks, riders in the sky assess their situation.
Okay, let's see what we've got. Woody, what's over there?
Looks like about 750 feet of sandstone, Ranger Doug.
Slim?
No way out here, Ranger Doug.
Side? Sidemeat? Not again. Sidemeat?
No, I'm over here. I found an old chest or something. I can't tell what it is in the dirt.
No.
Well, hang on there, Sidemeat. Fortunately, just before the landslide hit, I had time to grab my official Ranger Lantern.
Great thinking, Ranger Doug.
Thanks, Slim. It's that kind of thinking that's made me the idol of American youth. Let's just turn it on and see what we've got here. Looks like an old trunk of some kind.
Sure does. Hmm.
Must have been buried in the rim rock and the slide brought it down. Woody, how old do you think it is?
Well, let me see here, Ranger Doug. I can run a quick carbon test on it. I'd say it's between about 400 and 500 years old. I'm sorry I can't be more specific than that, Ranger Doug.
That's fine, Woody. You've done the best you could.
Let's bust that lock off and open her up. I'll bet she's full of Spanish gold.
Stand back. I got my tool kit and a holster here on me, fellas.
I don't know. I feel like we're tampering with something best left dead and buried.
Huh? Dead? Buried? Well,
good thinking, Slim. Perhaps we should examine it more carefully before we open it up.
Give me that tool kit and a holster. I'll show you how to examine it more carefully.
Oh, hey, hold on there, Sidemeat.
Oh! I got the lock off. Now let's just open her up and get a gander at them riches.
Yeah. Oh, no!
Wow! What's that eerie light?
What's that unearthly sound? A high-priced synthesizer effect?
Not on our budget, Slim. It's an osterizer.
What? Huh? An osterizer effect? Good heavens! Is this the end of Riders in the Sky? Texas Bix, can we lose the osterizer?
Oh, sure. Suddenly, it was strangely quiet.
Gosh, all that sound and fury, and then it just stopped.
Yeah, it just stopped. What was it all about, anyway? Hey, what's in that chest, Sidemeat? Gold? Silver?
Coffee pot.
Not exactly a coffee pot as we know them, Sidemeat. Probably used by some of the early conquistadores.
Wow, look at that coffee pot. Is it made out of gold?
Nah, looks like iron or brass. Let me dust it off a little bit here. I just kind of dust it.
Whoa!
What the?
It's a...
It's
a circus train!
No, it's not, Slim. It's a 7-foot-tall genie.
Ouch! Not much headroom out here. Greetings, I am the genie of the coffee pot. Thank you for freeing me. According to the tradition, I must grant you each a wish, but you must act quickly to receive this truly amazing offer. You have 60 seconds, beginning right now. Well, boys, this is a great opportunity, and it couldn't have come at a better time. Who'll go first?
I know what I want, Ranger Doug.
Okay, Slim, go on ahead.
Okay, Genie, I wish I was on a beautiful tropical island, lots of pretty girls, and one of those tall fruit drinks with a little umbrella in it.
Your wish is granted. 45 seconds and counting. Next. Woody.
Oh, gosh, this is too hard for
I'll be next. I'll be next. I know what I want.
Okay, go ahead, Sidemeat.
Oh, boy, that chance of a lifetime. Oh, what have I always wanted?
Oh, I got it. I want one of them Popeil pocket fishermen.
Oh,
give me one of them, Genie, will you?
You're sure? Well,
yes.
Your wish is granted.
Oh, boy, it's a beauty. Wow. I'll see you, boys. I'm a-going fishing. I'm on my way. Hey, wait a minute.
Sidemeat, that's the craziest thing I've ever seen.
30 seconds left, please, Woody.
You go ahead, Ranger Doug. I can't decide yet.
Okay, let's see. I wish I was high on Pearl Mesa, astride the amazing turbo, watching a beautiful western sunset across the purple plains of Tumbleweed Valley.
Yeah, me too.
Too late for you, old-timer.
Oh.
Don't worry, old partner. I'll come back for you. Your wish is granted. Hurry, hurry, time is running out.
Oh, no, I gotta decide, don't I?
Say, Woody, how about wishing for both of us to be out of here? I'll let you use my pocket fisherman.
You will?
We got some big ones with this thing. Oh, here, have a nice biscuit.
I don't want a biscuit.
Your time is almost up. You have only 10 seconds to make your wish or lose your chance forever. Ten, nine.
Come on, Woody. Eight, come on.
I don't know what to do. I need the whole trio here for a decision like
come
this.
On, Woody, come on.
Test. Gosh, I sure wish Slim and Doug were here.
Your wish is granted.
Woody!
Boy, am I glad to see you guys.
Let me at him.
Hold on, here, Slim. Hold on. That won't help.
I had a little umbrella and the drink and everything.
We've got to find a way out of here. Genie, help us. Sorry, Sahib. Speaking of out of here, have a nice day. I'm late for my class in motel management.
Well, there goes our last hope. Vanished in a puff of smoke.
Excuse me. Where is the door?
There ain't no door. We're trapped under tons of sandstone. Don't you get it?
Oh, no. This will not do.
Well, why don't you just wish yourself out of here, Genie?
If it was that easy, I would have got out of that coffee pot long ago.
Texas Bix, are we trapped in here with this guy?
Not only that, too, Slim, but you're running out of air.
Oh, no. Do something, Ranger Doug. Ranger Doug. Ranger Doug, talk to us.
Ranger Doug, are you okay?
Quiet, boys, quiet down. You're wasting air and I'm going to need it.
You're going to need it? What are you... You're going to do the
big number one yodel?
No need to go all the way, boys. Number six should do it. Stand back.
You better pull that turban down over your ears, Genie.
Oh, my. Hey,
The rocks, they're beginning to vibrate. Oh, wow.
As Ranger Doug performs his heroic yodel number six, two far too familiar figures finally reach their destination.
Ah, we're here at last. Now I'm going to really gloat over those crushed cowboys. But why is the ground vibrating? What's that unearthly noise?
I don't know, boss. Perhaps the rocks are settling.
Yeah. Hey, quick, Charlie. Let's get up on that tall boulder there.
Right, Slocum.
As the number six yodel reaches its zenith, tons of rock and boulder imploded and disintegrated into a fine, harmless dust. From the bowels of the sandstone, four weary cowpokes and one bewildered genie emerge into the light of day.
Wow, nice piece of yodeling, Ranger Doug.
Thanks, Woody. It's that kind of yodeling that's made me the idol of American youth. Free at last.
Oh, that was a close call. But thanks to Ranger Doug's yodeling, we're out of danger.
But are you too, Slim? High above, on a huge boulder, evil lurks.
Oh, no. Did they all get out? Count them off, Charlie.
Right. One, two. What comes after two, Slocum?
I'll count them. One, two, three, and there's the geezer. Wait a minute. Who's the guy with last week's laundry on his head?
It's a genie, boss. Genie comes from the Arabic word jinn, which
shut up, Charlie. Charlie, how many bullets you got left?
Just a second here. One, two,
Let me put it a different way, Charlie. How many empty chambers do you have in your pistol?
None, Slocum.
And how many bullets does it hold?
50. I stole it from Gene Autry.
Yeah. That's funny. Good work, Charlie. Now shoot him.
Okay, boss. Hey, Slocum.
What?
I don't like this. I never shot a guy from the front before.
I like that in a man, Charlie. Wait a few minutes and see if they turn around.
Right.
Meanwhile, down below, the riders get some parting advice from the genie of the coffee pot.
Well, I must be on my way now, but before I go, since you have any sense, freed me again, I should like to grant you some wishes.
Great. Right, yeah.
But I am out of wishes to grant.
Oh.
Still, I have some powers left, and I have some advice. If I were you, I would put one of Sidemeat's biscuits in my left shirt pocket. No. With Charlie's aim, better make that my right rear pocket.
Well, why on earth would we want to do that? What if we were to forget and sit down on them? Don't you know those things are...
The hardest substance known to man.
Precisely.
Gosh, what do you think, Ranger Doug?
I suspect we'd better do as he says, boys. Give us all a biscuit, side meat.
Okay, here you go, boy.
Put them in your pockets. Now, I must be going. Let's see. Barbara Eden's house is third on the left. No, back this way.
Okay, we'll have to turn around and say goodbye to him.
So long, Genie.
So long.
We hope our trails cross again.
Maybe so. Perhaps my people will be in touch with your people. Masalam. Have a nice day.
Gosh, I wonder who his people are.
Hey, he's gone.
Yeah. I wonder how long we'll have to keep these biscuits in our pockets.
Not long, Woody Paul.
Okay, Charlie. Now, while their backs are still turned.
Right, Slocum.
Oh! Right, Sam! Oh, they got me, too!
Nice piece of shooting, Charlie.
Thanks, Slocum. You want we should go down and bury him now?
Nah, let's leave a little smorgasbord for the buzzards. Come on, let's get back to the hideout. I got an important phone call to make.
All right, boss. Smorgasbord.
A cold wind swirls and plucks at four unmoving figures that lie crumpled on the hard ground beneath the sinking western sun. In the distance, a hungry coyote howls. Overhead, a flock of greedy buzzards, their wings flapping softly, circle their prey. Nearby, a sidewinder slithers across the rocky rubble. The snake is scared off as an emboldened buzzard lands. Yes, it's the infamous bumbling goonie buzzards of the Tumbleweed Valley.
Hey, Clyde, watch the wind shear.
Righting itself, the carrion-loving bird slowly extends its long, bony neck to tentatively nip the first piece of flesh from a still-warm body. Naturally, it pecks at what it thinks is the softest area and crumples its beak on
the hardest substance known to man.
Hey, who's that pecking at my back? Hey, you overgrown chicken, come here. I've got you by the neck here. I'm going to wring your little neck. Now all the rest of you get out of here. Go on, get away from my partners there. Go on, you buzzards.
Oh, that's better.
Hey, I feel like I've been kicked by a mule. Say, you boys all right? Ranger Doug.
I think so, Sidemeat, except a sore spot or two. Woody, Slim, you okay?
Oh, gosh.
Oh, yeah.
What happened? The last thing I remember was putting one of Sidemeat's biscuits in my back pocket. Well, it's the last time I'll ever do that.
I'm okay, Ranger Doug, I guess, but boy, my backside sure is sore. Ow!
Say, let me see those biscuits, boys. I have an idea. Look closely. These biscuits look like they've been shot.
Wow.
Woody, do a quick ballistics check on them.
All right, Ranger Doug. Let's see. Gosh, Ranger Doug, I'd say these markings are from a .44 caliber 50 shooter, like Gene Autry used to carry.
Gosh, Ranger Doug, what does all this mean, and who'd want to shoot a biscuit?
I don't know, Slim, but I think we'd all better sit down and talk all this over. Face it, we've had a terrible day.
Well, we sure have, Ranger Doug, but if you don't mind, I think I'll stand.
Mm. I see what you mean, Slim. Let's just lean on this big rock and talk it over. Perhaps we can find a pattern in these events.
Yeah, maybe we can. Well, it all started this morning when we lost the herd in that stampede, boys.
And then the bunkhouse burned to the ground.
Yeah, and then the landslide trapped us.
And then we were shot in our biscuits.
I know. The more I think about it, the more I can't help but think, someone's out to get us.
Really, Ranger Doug?
But why?
I don't know. But I do know that it's been a rough day, and we could all use a good meal. Sidemeat, can you rustle us up any grub?
You bet. Buzzards and beans coming up.
Say, what in tarnation is that thing driving?
It's a circus train!
It is not, Slim. It's a jugmobile.
Oh.
Howdy, Ranger Doug, Woody Paul, Sidemeat, and Too Slim. Say, Too Slim. You look a lot like Ed Sullivan.
Well, you know, I hear that all the time.
What you sound like.
I know, Richard Nixon.
Hey, why don't you fellas, all y'all climb down here and join us?
Thanks, we will.
Yeah, just pull up a rock and sit down. We prefer to stand, but don't let that stop you. What brings you to these parts?
Well, we're on our way home from the Ed Sullivan Show.
I thought as much.
Hey, how about a heaping plate of buzzards and beans? I got plenty. Thank you kindly, but we ate this yesterday, and we are real full. Uh-huh. Well, sit down anyway and sing us one of them crazy songs you do. Let's get the gal Jill Klein up here to sing a number for us.
Mosh!
Yeah, right.
to do. Sometimes I sit and sigh and then begin to cry, 'cause my best friend said his last goodbye. There's a change in the ocean, change in the deep blue sea, my baby. I tell you folks, there ain't no change in me. My love for that man will always be. Now I got him, now I got the crazy blue. But what you're gonna need is an undertaker, man. I ain't had nothing but bad news. Lord, I got the crazy blues.
I can't sleep at night. I can't sleep at night. I'm thinking of my Lord. She don't treat me right.
Music and good food has got me sleepy.
Yeah, me too, Ranger Doug. We'll get him tomorrow, whoever's trying to get us.
Yeah, I'm not going to worry about it right now. Good night, everybody.
All right, fellas, I'm going to bed down too.
We'll all be sleeping on our stomachs tonight.
And so after a long, hard day's journey into night, the Sandman's dreamy curtain falls on our weary cowpokes.
Psst.
Suddenly, a psst pierces the night.
Psst. Texas Bix, hey.
Oh, what is it, Ranger Doug?
Look, isn't every episode of Meltdown on the Mesa supposed to end with a cliffhanger?
That's exactly right, Ranger Doug.
Oh, where is it?
Suddenly, without warning, the ground opened up and swallowed our sleeping cowboy.
I'm sorry, I...
Oh, no!
Oh, this is like a terrible nightmare.
Texas Bix, Ranger Doug, help me.
Slim, Slim, two Slim, wake up. Wake up, partner, you're having a nightmare.
What? Yeah, wake up, Slim.
What in thunderation's going on?
Slim's just having a bad dream.
Wait, we're not falling?
Oh, no, no, you're not falling at all. You're okay.
I guess maybe that buzzard was a little ripe. Of course, it could have been the earthquake beans.
What a relief. I dreamed the earth opened up and swallowed us up. It didn't really happen, I guess.
No, it didn't really happen, Slim. It was just a cheesy plot device that Texas Bix came up with at the end of last week's episode.
Well, heck, I don't think I can go back to sleep now, fellas.
No, me either.
Well, there's plenty of night left. Toss another log on the fire there, Slim.
Oh, okay.
I think I'll warm us up a pot of joe. What do you think, boy?
Good idea, yeah. Sidemeat. Better make it decaf, though, or we'll never get back to sleep.
No, decaf. No, shoo, namby-pamby. I'll make it a good 30 weight by Ned. No.
Boy, that fire sure does feel good, fellas. Say, Ranger Doug, was that really just a number 6 yodel you used to get us out of that landslide back there?
Sure was, Woody.
Boy, Ranger Doug, tell us again how you learned that yodel. That's such a great story.
Yeah.
Well, as you boys know, it's really part of a bigger story.
Yeah, of how you became a ranger
back when you were Deputy Doug.
Well, that's right, it was. It all began long ago, right here in the...
Hold on now, hold on. Wait for me. I want to hear this tale, too. Here you go, boy. Here's some coffee for you.
Thanks, Sidemeat.
Thanks, Sidemeat.
Okay.
Go ahead, Ranger Doug.
All set?
Tell us again about the yodel and the peach.
Well, let's see. It all began many years ago, like I say, right here in the old Triple X. And, well, say, maybe I could get Texas Bix to give me a hand here.
I'd be glad to, Ranger Doug. It all began many years ago.
Beautiful job, Texas Bix. And Woody, perhaps you could give us a little transitional music.
Yes, it was many years ago. Ranger Doug, then Deputy Doug, had responded to an amazing offer on the back of a matchbook cover. A mail order course leading to a ranger degree.
Gosh, isn't it about time to blow out that candle and go to sleep, Deputy Doug?
What time is it anyway?
It's past midnight, Slim, but I can't put the candle out yet. I'm taking my final exams to become a ranger.
So that's why you've been doing all that roping and riding, target shooting, brass polishing, and teeth flossing.
Right you are, Slim. I'm not going to be a banjo player at Shakey's the rest of my life. I'm going to be a ranger.
Gosh.
Well, I guess it might be a pretty good idea to have a ranger around the house.
2 weeks later.
Mail call for riders in the sky. Let's see here in the mailbag. A Western Horseman, that's for me. Oh, here's the new Fredericks of Deadwood catalog for you, Woody.
Oh, boy, thanks, Slim. Wow, look at these peekaboo cinches. Wow.
Hey, let me have a gander
at
that.
Hey, get your own, you old coot.
Here's a package for you, Sidemeat.
Oh, it's my new Christie Lane 8-track, Monk.
did you get the book, too, old-timer?
No, I don't like reading all that much.
Deputy Doug, this big brown envelope's for you.
Gosh, my ranger test grades.
How'd you do?
Let's see. Western history, A+.
Oh.
Tracking, A+.
Oh.
Ranger lore, A+.
Wow.
Western vocabulary, you old sidewinder, A+.
Oh, boy. Gee.
Script reading, C+.
Oh.
That's okay. It's an elective.
Well, gosh, Deputy Doug, does that mean you're a ranger now?
No, not yet, Woody. It says right here I have one more test to pass. I must go on a quest into the wilderness of East Texas.
A quest?
A quest?
For what?
To meet the perfect master ranger.
Well, let's saddle up.
Yeah, let's get going.
Hold it right there, boys. I have to go on this one alone.
We thought you might say that.
And so it was that a few weeks later, Deputy Doug, astride his young, impetuous pony, Beetlebomb, found himself trekking through the great dismal swamp of East Texas.
Come on, Beetlebomb. Gotta keep going. Come on, boy. I know it's muddy, filthy, and dismal. We can't rest until we find the perfect master ranger. Come on, boy, lift those feet up. It's only mud. Come on, pick up those...
It's not mud. It's quicksand. You're sinking. I'm sinking. We're sinking. It's up to your forelegs. Oh, you're up to your chest. If I get my rope, I'll last to that tree and... I can't get it. You're up to your neck, and so am I. Is this the end? Have I failed in my quest? Take a deep breath and hold it, Beetle Bob. Maybe we can...
Excuse me. May I be of some assistance?
What? Who the... You bet you can, Shorty. Throw me a rope and do it quick.
No need for that. Be quiet while I concentrate.
It's going to take a lot more than concentration, pal. Just stop squinting them beady little eyes and furrowing that fuzzy little brow. Why are you holding your hand out like that? Throw that rope. Can't you see I'm sinking?
Quiet, hey, I said. Quiet.
For a harrowing second, horse and rider sink from sight in the pool of quicksand is calm. Then, amazingly... A slimy, covered deputy and his bewildered horse emerge from their murky doom and float to safety, coming to rest beside the extraordinary little creature with a fuzzy brow.
Wow! That was some trick, pal! Say, how'd you do it?
It was nothing. I simply called upon the force of the cowboy way.
The... cowboy way? Then you must be the perfect master ranger.
You may call me Yodel. I am at your service.
Howdy, Yodel. I'm Deputy Doug.
This I know.
And this is my horse, Beetle Bomb.
Excuse me?
I said this is my horse, Beetle Bomb.
An unusual name for a horse.
Well, he's an unusual horse. I've come on a quest. I seek to be a ranger.
This I know. I have seen your written scores. Very impressive.
Oh, shucks.
You were not in St. Louis when they were passing out the brains in Chickasha, Oklahoma.
Well, gee willikers.
Still, your greatest test lies ahead.
This I know.
That's my line.
This I know.
Let's stop now, okay? Don't say that anymore.
Okay.
Now you must answer for me 3 questions correctly. Then will I give to you the power of yodel.
Okay. Shoot.
No need for that. Question number 1. Can you rope the wild wind, ride like a prairie fire, and track a fugitive across a burning desert for days on end without water?
Oh, heck yeah, I can.
This I know. Question number 2. What was the name of Smiley Burnett's horse in the old barn dance, Republic Picture 1938? No coaching, please.
I don't need no coaching for that one, Yodel. It was... Ring-Eyed Nelly.
This I know. Question number 3 is an essay question. In 500 words or less, explain the cowboy way.
Oh, golly. Well, I'll tell you what it means to me, Yodel. When I get to a place in life when the road forks and I don't know which way to go.
Yes.
Or when I'm caught between the Scylla and Charybdis of a difficult
Excuse
choice.
Me?
The more... A rock and a hard place.
Oh. This I know. I was just checking. I'm glad I said 500 words or less. Continue, please.
So, when I have a tough decision like that to make, I simply ask myself, what would Gene or Tex or Roy do? And what they do is the cowboy way.
Congratulations. Here is your ranger badge. Pin it on, because from this day forward, Deputy Doug is no more. Long live Ranger Doug!
Thanks, Yodel. I've waited a long time for this moment.
Believe me, so have we. Now that you are a ranger, I will give you the key to the power of the cowboy way.
Thanks, Yodel. What is it?
F flat. It's a little yodel joke there. Listen, let me hear you yodel.
Okay. Odelay! Hello.
That's not bad. That's not bad. Try a little experiment. Do you see that boulder jutting out of the swamp over there?
You mean the one that's about 15 feet high, about 10 feet wide, and weighs around, 100 tons?
Yes, that's the one. See if you can pulverize it.
It's a big job, but I'll try it. Where's the hammer?
No. Just use your voice.
My voice?
Yes.
Okay, if you say so.
Hey, you! Break up, Rock!
Hey! Hey! Shatter! Pulverize! Hey, you! I'm talking to you, buddy! Hey!
Ranger Doug! Those test scores, you must have fudged... No, of course not.
That wouldn't be... Well, you know.
I know. Listen to me. You must draw from within. You simply do not understand the powers you possess. Watch me. Ahem. Your lady, old lady, old lady, old lady, old lady.
Wow. That rock is pulverized into a fine, harmless dust. Say, how did you do that?
With the number six yodel? Nothing can withstand the power of yodel.
The number six yodel? How many yodels are there?
10 in the known universe. The strongest is the pig number one. It is the most powerful force known to man.
Wow, a yodel?
Yes. To perform it, you must be able to stand above the rest. You must be pure of heart and strong of mind. Must be equal to any test. Have grit and gumption. Be brave and true. Have teeth that won't quit. Ranger Doug, that man is you.
Yodel? I stand before you, ready to learn.
It is best to start small. See if you can blow up this peach.
Peach.
But remember, when you yodel, you must focus all your energy in your epiglottis. And if you are acting for truth, justice, and the cowboy way, nothing can stand in your way.
I thought as much.
Yes.
Hey, yolo, yolo, hey, yolo, yolo, yolo.
Not bad. You didn't explode it, but...
I peeled it.
Yes! You have the basic knowledge now. As you grow in character and strength, living your life the cowboy way, your yodel too will grow.
Thank you, yodel.
Go now. I have much to do, and I am tired and must rest. Life is not easy for a 2-foot-tall, furry little cow person.
Thanks again, yodel.
Yes.
Come on, Beetlebum.
Wait a moment. I cannot send a new ranger out into the world on a horse named Beetlebum. Come here, horsey. Let me look into your soft brown eyes. Yes. Ranger Doug, like yourself, this horse has powers he does not know. Focus on him, and as you grow, he will grow. And when you need him, he will be there. But he can be Beetlebum no more. I christen him Amazing Turbo! Go now, Ranger Duck. The path lies before you. It is the cowboy way.
I'll never forget you, Yodel. Goodbye. And now, on Turbo, on boy!
And so began the saga, Ranger Doug, his horse the Amazing Turbo, and the cowboy way.
Oh, that campfire feels good.
Yeah.
Gosh, Ranger Doug, that's such a great story.
I never get tired of hearing it. But boy, now that it's over, I sure am tired.
I know what you mean, Slim. Let's douse the fire and turn in.
Well, we still... Nice shot there, Woody. We still got a mess of troubles, but they can keep.
Yeah, I guess they can.
Boys, good first night, thing y'all. In the morning... I'll go up to the high pasture and get Turbo and the other horses. Then we can start checking this all out all over the valley. Good night, boys.
Good night.
Well, that sure was a short night.
Short but refreshing.
It's another beautiful morning on the range. Too bad things look so bleak for us.
Boy, we're in a heap of trouble, all right. Things really look bleak. We ain't got no herd. Our mortgage payment's due the day after tomorrow, and we got no roof over our head, and gosh, we don't have anything to eat.
I know it looks bad, boys, but say, let's count our blessings.
Yeah,
I guess we've still got each other.
And we've still got our instruments and our God-given talent.
Yeah.
We're in more trouble than I thought.
No, we're not, Sidemeat. Boys, we could salvage some timbers and build a stage.
We're going in the overland business?
I could play my guitar, and Yodel and Turbo could do some tricks.
I could sing and play my bass and my face.
Gosh, yes, I could do my rope routine and play my fiddle.
Boys, we could...
We could put on a show!
Great, I'll cater it.
Oh, no need for that, Sidemeat. We'll have the folks bring covered dishes or something.
Yeah, I know. We'll have a big benefit dance and invite all our friends over from Tumbleweed Valley.
It'll be a blast.
How right you are, Too Slim, for even as you speak, a bad actor named Slocum is setting a stage of his own.
Yeah. Hello, Mr. Biggs. Slocum here. What? Of course I know the code. Oh, all right. Hello, hey. Ister May Igsbay. Listen, no more riders in the ice gay. Yeah, we shot him a couple episodes ago. And tonight we can bring the reactor on Einlay. Yeah, trust me. What do you think, Arlie Chay?
Huh?
Forget it.
As the morning sun warms Tumbleweed Valley, riders in the sky set out to revive their fading fortunes.
Okay, let's get organized, boys. Woody and Slim, pull some of those timbers together and build us a stage. I'll head up to the high pasture and get Turbo and the other horses. Then I'll put up posters announcing tonight's show all over the valley. Let's get going, boys.
Great plan, Ranger Doug. We don't have much in the way of tools, just a couple of hammers and our God-given two hands. But we'll get a stage built. Right, Woody?
Right you are, Slim. Come on, let's get started.
Okay, we'll put the yodeldrome over here.
Yeah, this will be
That's
good.
That's the cowboy way. I'll be back soon, fellas.
Ranger Doug.
What?
And now's a great chance to put my SDI into effect. You remember talking about it 7 or 8 episodes ago, don't you?
I'm afraid I probably don't.
Sure you do. My SDI, Sidemeat Defense Initiative. I burn money for fuel, I float around up in a balloon, and when intruders show up, I pop them with biscuits made out of the...
hardest substance known to man.
Well, what do you say?
Oh, Sidemeat.
What?
Let's talk about this later. Right now, we've got to get this place spruced up for the dance. There'll be a lot of nice ladies here, and... we want it to look awfully good.
Oh, women. Oh, not for me. Oh.
Well, I'll just take matters into my own hands.
Oh.
I got
more biscuits to make, more balloons to launch, more money to burn, more.
Later that afternoon, two malevolent sociopaths gallop down the main trail to town.
Hold it, Charlie.
What is it, Slocum?
I want to read the poster on this tree. Yeah, Let's see. Big benefit show and dance, huh? Starring Riders in the Sky and Joey the Cow-Polka King, Triple X Ranch, 7 o'clock tomorrow night? Wait a minute. They're not only not dead, they're giving a dance. Charlie, do you know what this means?
Yeah, boss, it means we gotta shave and polish our
boots. No! You idiot! It means we gotta get back to the hideout and make some new plans. Plans that turn this revolting development into a benefit for us. Yeah, us.
A benefit, right.
But despite sociopaths, voodoo economics, and Middle Eastern unrest, Riders in the Sky roll their big sleeves up and do what they do best. Put on a show.
At the Cowboy Jubilee.
And by evening of the next day, the show is underway and a huge success.
Hey! Wow. Thank you, Saddlebound. Thank you. We sure do appreciate all of you coming out for our big benefit and dance. As you know, we really had a bad day here yesterday, but I think we've raised enough money here tonight to meet our mortgage payment, start to restore our herd, get a new Vaughn Monroe poster, and build a new wing on the orphanage as well. It's time to introduce our special guest. Slim, do you want to do the honors?
Wonderful and wonderful. Dank you, Ranger Dog.
Slim,
yes.
That is the worst Ed Sullivan imitation I've ever heard.
It's Lawrence Welk, a Ranger Dog.
Sound more like Richard Nixon to me.
Well, just get on with it, will you?
Thank you, boys. Now, ladies and gentlemen, here with the 140, young at heart, is a Joey the Cow Polka King playing the mortgage payment polka. Joey!
While merriment and frivolity prevail at the Big Riders' benefit, Slocum and Charlie, as you might expect, are planning a surprise ending to the day's events, as we shall shortly see. But first...
boys, I think we'd better put a couple of extra guards on duty tonight.
Why, Ranger Doug?
Well, I hear Slocum and Charlie are planning a little surprise for us.
Gosh, where'd you hear that, Ranger Doug?
Well, Texas Bix Bender just said it. Weren't you listening?
No, I wasn't.
Me neither. There's so much going on.
Yeah, it's hard to keep up with all these plot convolutions.
I guess that's why Ranger Doug's the idol of American youth.
Indeed it is too slim, for even as the extra guards take up their positions, Ranger Doug's theory is borne out. Slocum and Charlie arrive at the dance, but remain unseen in a small cottonwood grove nearby.
Now, Slocum?
No, Charlie, not yet. Wait till everybody's gathered around all teary-eyed, singing happy trails. Then make your little withdrawal. They'll be too sappy to react.
Right, Slocum. Sappy.
Yeah, I'll see you back at the hideout. I gotta let Mr. Biggs know I'm bringing the reactor online tonight.
Right.
By the way, be extra careful. I hear they put some extra guards on duty.
Right. Say, Slocum, where'd you hear that?
On the radio. Texas Bix just mentioned it. Weren't you listening?
Yeah, but I guess I just missed it.
I guess that's why I'm the boss around here. I got the brains.
Brains? Oh, you think that's the reason, is it?
Yeah.
Brains? What makes you think you've got any brains, Slocum?
Hey, Charlie. Hey, I don't like the way you're acting.
Oh, yeah? Well, don't you think you're overplaying it a little yourself?
Yeah. Well. Yeah. Look, you get the money, shoot the accordion player, and I'll see you back at the hideout.
Right.
Meanwhile, floating in the dark sky, high above these two hams, is the familiar, wizened figure of yet another player in tonight's melodrama.
Yeah, I better throw another chip on the fire and see if I can get any higher.
Boy, I wish...
Wow,
that was a light one. I wish I had some money to burn.
Hey, that looks like Slocum down there. I wonder what that sidewinder's up to. I think I'll just tag along and see.
Thank you, Saddletown. We're now speaking for all of us to all of you.
Happy trails to you until we meet again. Happy trails to you.
Ah! We've been robbed! Oh, no!
Oh, get the horses, boys! Are you all right, Miss Marm?
Yes, but he got all the money!
Here are the horses, Ranger Doug.
Which way did he go, Miss Marm?
He went that way!
I thought as much. Ready, boys?
Ready, Ranger Doug. Say, Joey, how about some chase music?
Let's ride!
There he is, over there on the crest of that hill.
He's getting away.
There he is, on the crest of that hill,
he's
boys.
He's getting away.
Joey, could you play just a little bit faster? We'll never catch him at that tempo.
It's working. We're gaining on him. Oh, no.
Oh, he's shooting at us, boys.
Ride low in the saddle, boys.
Oh, that's six shots. He ought to be empty now. Now we got him.
What? Oh, no. He must have a Gene Autry 50 shooter.
Meanwhile, in a remote, narrow ravine deep in the bowels of Tumbleweed Valley, inside a carefully camouflaged stainless steel structure with twin cooling towers cleverly designed to look like huge ponderosa pines, a diabolical laugh splits the air.
That's right, Mr. Biggs. This is Slocum. I'm just calling to let you know that I'm bringing the reactor online, even as we speak. Soon this whole valley, the entire West, the beef business everywhere will be ours.
Meanwhile, in the dark, moonless sky, high above Slocum's camouflaged reactor.
Where'd he go? I followed Slocum to this remote ravine in the bowels of Tumbleweed Valley.
And then he disappeared.
I wonder if he went into that carefully camouflaged stainless steel deal down there. Next to them two huge ponderosa pines. Man, that's the biggest I've ever seen.
Meanwhile, back at the chase.
He's finally out of bullets, but my horse is tiring.
Boy, mine is tired too. Boy, he's really on a fast horse.
Yes, he is, Woody Paul, but not too fast for Ranger Doug on Amazing Turbo, the wonder horse of the West.
Gosh, he's right, Ranger Doug. You can catch him on Turbo.
Don't wait for us. Ride, Ranger Doug, ride.
On Turbo, on boy.
Wow! Look at him go!
Meanwhile, back at Slocum's reactor hideout.
No, Mr. Biggs. I designed it myself. I can tell you absolutely nothing can go wrong. It's foolproof, I tell you. Well, sure, there's an air intake on the roof. You have to have one. Well, I suppose it is possible, but look here, Mr. Big. That thing's just a vertical pipe. It sticks up maybe 2 inches. It's no wider than a biscuit. Well, no, I didn't put a screen over it. The possibility's so remote. Well, sure, if a foreign object were to be introduced at critical mass, which is seconds from now, but I tell you, that's next to impossible, and not only that. It would have to be the
hardest substance known to man.
Meanwhile, high above Slocum's evil edifice.
Oh, come on, show yourself, Slocum. I got a biscuit here with your name on it.
Whoops! Oh, I dropped that one.
Well, there's plenty more where that came from.
Yes, the odds against this happening are 60 septimajillion to one. But when you live your life the cowboy way, those aren't bad odds. As Slocum is about to find out.
So relax, Mr. Biggs. Nothing can go... Mr. Biggs, listen, I gotta go. Oh, yeah, it's my teapot. Yeah, funny sounding whistle. Well, I gotta go. It's definitely boiling over. Well, I'll get back to you. Bye. Gotta get out of here.
Attention, attention. 10 minutes until critical mass. Evacuate, evacuate. Kiss your...
And as Slocum steps outside to flee his melting reactor, a nemesis with his name on it zips down from above and connects with his cranium.
Ouch! Ouch! What the?
Take that!
Oh! Ouch! Where are those things coming from? Boy, those are hard!
Meanwhile, back at the chase... Ranger Doug on Amazing Turbo has caught up with an amazed Charlie.
What the?
And with a flying leap, Ranger Doug knocks Charlie from his horse.
Why, you? Take that. And that. And that. And that for shooting at a poor unarmed accordion player.
No more. No more. I quit. Okay, okay.
You got him, Ranger Doug.
Way to go, Ranger Doug.
Okay, Charlie, spill the beans, or do you want some more fistic medicine?
Yeah, give him another dose of medicine, Ranger Doug.
No more medicine. It was Slocum, see? He was behind it all. He stampeded your herd. He burned the bunkhouse. He started the landslide back in episode 2. He did it. He did it all.
I thought as much. Where is Slocum now?
Yeah, where is he?
He's just over the hill there, see, in this hidden ravine. He's up to no good over there, I can tell you that.
Well, That's about where the old Will You Be Mine is, Ranger Doug.
Right you are, Woody. Come on, boys. Let's go pay a call on Mr. Slocum. Get on your horse, Charlie.
Right, Ranger Doug. Pay a call on Slocum. He said shoot the accordion player.
Meanwhile, just over the hill in the hidden ravine.
Ouch! Ouch!
Sidemeat has Slocum pinned down when a sudden updraft carries him away.
Whoa! They've stopped at last. But I gotta get out of here before this baby takes me on a free fall to Beijing.
But before Slocum can make his getaway...
Whoa, hold it right there, Slocum.
Now what?
Charlie's been filling us in on your perfidious activity.
Yeah, he hasn't shut up yet.
Yeah, and see, he's building this reactor here to create mutant prairie dogs, see, that look like cattle.
Prairie dogs? Oh, you are evil!
Like I said, he's the one who stampeded your herd.
Quiet, you idiot!
He's responsible for Black Monday, see? Designer jeans and moonlighting and new Coke, and he's behind the Gretzky trade, see? And
Pink Lady. Shut up, you idiot!
Slocum, Charlie's testimony will put you away where you belong.
Oh, yeah? You didn't know I had this gun behind my back?
He's got a gun.
Okay, reach for the sky. I always wanted to say that. Now, I'm in control again. Of course, it doesn't make any difference. I'm going to hell, but I'm taking you with me.
That'll be the day, Slocum.
Oh, yeah, see that little reactor behind me? It's gonna blow. The only thing that could save this valley is 30 million gallons of cool, clear water. So just sit tight while we wait for the big meltdown on the mesa. Ow, my hand. Ouch, I dropped the gun.
I got it. I got the gun.
Oh,
hands
no.
up, Slocum.
Where are those things coming from?
Howdy, boys.
Sidemeat.
Just then, another sudden updraft carries Sidemeat away again.
Hey, damn it.
Gosh. Maybe he'll make it to safety.
Maybe he will, but the rest of us won't. Our chances aren't worth a Tinker's Dam.
Tinker's Dam? Say, that's only 30 miles from here. Woody, how many gallons of water are behind Tinker's Dam?
Let's see, Ranger Doug. It's a mile long, a quarter mile wide, and about 800 feet deep. I'd say about 30 million gallons, Ranger Doug.
Ride, Ranger Doug, ride!
Ride, Ranger!
Not enough time, Tuesday. This calls for the ultimate.
You mean the big number one yodel?
I do.
But Ranger Doug, that'll deafen every prairie dog for 30 miles.
That can't be helped, Too Slim. It's a small price to pay to save the Western world.
Ha! Tell that to the prairie dogs.
I can't. There's no time now, and later they'll be unable to hear me. Stand back, everyone.
Hit the dirt, everybody!
What's up? My ears! This is not my day! Ranger Doug, you did it! You cracked Tinker's Dam in the nick of time! I don't think my ears could have lasted another second!
Thank goodness I didn't have to go all the way.
We're all gonna be drowned, you idiots, if the reactor doesn't blow up first!
Grab a hold of something solid!
Okay!
Not me, Slocum!
Grab hold of these ropes, boys!
Side me!
Thanks, sidekick! Hey, Turbo! Turbo! Guide the other horses to safety on Turbo!
And so 30 million gallons of cool, clear water roared down the valley and smashed into Slocum's reactor, cooling it down and disappearing almost as fast as it came. Turbo and the other horses reached safety. And since Ranger Doug didn't have to go all the way, the prairie dogs weren't deafened. And as for riders in the sky, they, along with Slocum and Charlie, are safe, dangling high above it all from Sidemeat's chip-powered hot air balloon.
Wow, that was fast. Where did it all go?
Well, as I mentioned in the last episode, Slim, this reactor was built on the old Will Ya Be mine, and there's a huge cavern beneath it.
Yeah, my reactor's gone, but this valley's gonna be hot for eons.
Maybe so, but Woody, wasn't the old Will Ya Be mine a lead mine?
Right you are, Ranger Doug. The walls of that cavern down there are almost solid lead. It'll hold that nuclear waste for the 250,000 years needed to neutralize it. Of course, it'll need a cap of the
hardest substance known to man.
Biscuits, you say?
Ma, give me $7 for flour and we're in business. Ma!
Oh, side meat.
Oh, side meat. Oh, come on.
And so, riders in the sky, save Tumbleweed Valley. With the reward money from the capture of Slocum and Charlie and the money from the big benefit, the riders were able to rebuild their bunkhouse, find a new Bomb and Row poster, and restore the herd. There was even enough money left over to build two new hospitals and a modern daycare center for working mothers. Yes, all was quiet. Perhaps too quiet.
Hey, Sheriff. Don't I get to make one phone call? Everybody gets a phone call.
Oh, I suppose so. Hold on, I'll bring it in there to you. Just wait a minute.
All right. I'll just talk to my cellmate here. So, buddy, what you in here for?
Well, I don't rightly know. I was playing on this here big radio show, and I thought I'd done real good. Time come for me to go maybe get a check, and the high sheriff come in and arrested me. I asked him what for, and he said, well, at the end of the show, I'd understand. It's almost over, and I ain't got a clue. Unless there's some cheesy plot device going on in here.
You might be onto something there.
Here's the phone, buddy. Make it quick.
Yeah, Uncle Dave, how about a little background music there?
Well, all right.
Yeah, all right. Yeah. Yeah. That ought to do it. Hello. Yeah, Mr. Biggs, this is you-know-who. No, I don't need the code. No one can hear me. I'm on the set of Hee Haw. Listen, Mr. Biggs, time to play hardball. Jailer, I'm through with the phone.
All right. Well, what about that banjo player in there?
Well, I'm through with him, too.
Yeah. All right, son, you can go now. I just got a pardon here for you.
Well, that's fine. I guess I enjoyed being on the show, boys. What about that check now?
Well, that's all right. You just go ahead and run along now. We don't do things like that around here.
A full week has passed since the aborted meltdown on the Mesa. Now it is a beautiful Saturday afternoon. Our dauntless trio arrives in Tumbleweed Sally on us. Valley. Our dauntless trio arrives in Tumbleweed City on a special project.
Well, here we are, boys. I didn't think we'd make it. Whoa.
Yeah, great, Ranger Doug.
You bet, Ranger Doug. Thanks to our dauntless announcer. Gosh, what a way to spend a Saturday afternoon.
Do I detect a splinter of discontent in you fellers?
Ranger Doug, we've been working hard all week. We finally get an afternoon off, and what do? Play a benefit at the county jail.
God, Ranger Doug, one of the guys in the jail there is Slocum, the guy that destroyed our ranch and tried to kill us.
Not to mention the mutant prairie dogs he was going to create.
Boys, I know how you feel. And there's plenty of justification for it, too.
But yeah.
Slocum is in jail now, like the other unfortunate souls in there. He deserves a chance at rehabilitation, even if he is a morally polluted felon. Oh, I know you've worked hard all week long, and it would be the easy way to just go fishing,
yeah,
practice rope tricks, or call on the school teacher, Miss Marm. Yes, that would be the easy way, all right, but it wouldn't be the cowboy way.
Gosh, you're right as rain, Ranger Doug.
Yeah, what are we waiting for? Come on, boys. Let's roll our big sleeves up and put on a show.
Okay.
Meanwhile, deep within the moldering gray stone walls of the Tumbleweed Jail, in a cramped 4x4 cell, a solitary and very morally polluted felon sits and sulks.
Why me? Why did everything have to go wrong? Even my lackey Charlie betrayed me. Mr. Biggs had better get to those crooked weasels on the parole board and arrange my pardon. Then I'll get those cornball cowboys. Even their names drive me crazy.
Hey, Slocum, we're having a benefit this afternoon in the jail gymnasium.
Yeah.
You want to come?
Yeah, benefit, eh? Who's playing at it?
Well, the Riders in the Sky. Yeah, I'm pretty excited about it, too. Matter of fact, I'm supposed to sing at the thing myself.
Oh,
I believe it'll be a pretty good career move for me.
Yeah, you bet. Take it away, pal.
I'm not going to be doing this high sheriff jailing business all my life, you know. I aim to be a major country recording artist someday.
Yeah, well, good luck, pal.
Well, I got to finish my rounds, and I'll be back for you.
Yeah, right.
Meanwhile, in the narrow alley behind the jail, a hulking 300-pound doofus creeps cat-like through the shadows. And moves to the barred window of a particular cell. Suddenly, a psst pierces the night.
What's that noise?
It's a psst. Slocum, didn't you hear me? It's me, Charlie. We're here at your window.
Charlie, you double-crossing snake. What are you doing here?
Well, they let me go in return for my testimony against you.
Great.
So I came by to say hi.
Yeah.
See if I could do anything for you.
You've done enough, you rat.
Okay, boss. I'll be seeing you.
Yeah, good riddance. Say, wait a minute. What if that pardon can't be worked out? I gotta get out of here now. Charlie, wait. Wait, here. Wait, Charlie.
What is it, boss?
Look, what the heck? No use crying over spilt milk, eh, Charlie?
Right.
What's a little state's evidence between friends? Let's let bygones be bygones and all that hogwash. What do you say?
Okay, Slocum, sure.
Look, you gotta bust me out of this can. I've been waiting for Mr. Biggs to arrange a little pardon, if you know what I mean.
Right,
but I can't wait anymore. You gotta bust these bars out of this window, Charlie.
Sure, whatever you say. I can't pull these bars out, boss.
Of course not, Charlie. You gotta get some dynamite, you idiot.
Oh, right. I'll be right back.
All right, Charlie.
It's about this time in every show that High Sheriff Drywall knows he'd better check on his prisoner.
Mr. Slocum?
Yeah, what?
There was something I was going to tell you.
What is it?
I forgot what it was.
Well,
I guess it'll come to me eventually.
Yeah, well,
let's see if you can't remember it. Say, you know, it ain't no good no way.
Yeah, well, listen, maybe I've got a plan B here. Listen, High Sheriff.
Well, how back at you?
Yeah. Funny. You're a funny guy. Say, let me ask you a personal question, Sheriff. How long you been sheriff around here?
Sir?
9 or 10, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, that'd be what you would say.
9 or 10 years, I guess.
I guess you've been properly compensated for all those years.
Sir?
You've been well paid.
Oh, yeah, I get $2 a week and grub. It ain't very bad in these times.
Well, what would $3 a week sound like?
Well, I wouldn't know.
Well, listen. Well?
Well, what?
How did that sound to you?
Sound like clink, clink, clink. Well,
yeah, exactly. Now, do you suppose you can lose that cell door key you got there?
What? Lose this key?
Yeah.
No way. I did lose it once when I first got this job, but that taught me a lesson, buddy, I'll tell you. I keep it tied on here with baling wire now.
Yeah.
no way in the world I could lose it now.
So there's no way you could lose the key?
No way.
Not even for this.
Sir? Wait a minute. Let me get this straight. You mean all I gotta do is lose this key and you'll give me all them clinks? I mean, money?
Yeah, right. Go to the head of the class, Sheriff.
Well, all right, then. That's a deal. Give me the money.
All right, here you go. Nice report card. All A's. Now, why don't you lose the key right by the cell door here?
Well, that'd be a pretty poor place to lose it now, wouldn't it?
No, you gotta lose it right here. See, where I can...
Anybody having by it know right where it was.
No, I gotta be able to reach it here. So
hey,
you gotta...
buddy, no, sorry. Somebody paid me this kind of money to lose something. I'm gonna lose it real good.
Now, wait a minute. Hey, wait a minute, Sheriff. Get back here. Wait, no. Come back. You idiot!
You called, boss?
Charlie!
Right. I'm back with the dynamite.
Great. Back to plan B. Pack it under the wall.
I already did, boss. I just need something to light the fuse with.
I don't have any matches either.
Me neither.
Oh, duck down. The sheriff's back.
Well, I got that done. Nobody will ever find them keys.
Yeah, great.
Hey, Slocum, it's time for the big benefit show now. You want to go or not?
Nah, I hate cowboy music, but say, got a match? I'd like a smoke.
A match? You want a smoke?
Yeah, give me a match here. What do you say?
I reckon so, but you take it over by the window now. You know, I don't like all that smoke in here.
Yeah, great idea.
I gotta go back here and practice my song. I'm gonna get to sing one at the big benefit. I've been writing one.
Yeah, great.
But I haven't got to finish yet. What? Yeah. What rhymes with heart?
Well, Kmart. How about that? All right, Charlie.
What, boss?
Here you go.
Right.
Great, Charlie. Sure the dynamite is packed good and tight under this wall?
Right, boss. All the walls.
All the walls? How many sticks did you use?
Well, I used one, two, and... What'd you say came after two, boss?
Never mind. Look at my hand. Yeah. Was it more than this many?
Oh, yeah. I did a real good job,
Wait
boss.
A minute. Was it more than this many?
Sure. Lots more, boss.
I don't have any more fingers left. Charlie, hold all your fingers up here next to mine.
Uh-huh.
That's it. No, it wasn't more than this many.
Oh, lots more than that, boss.
God,
say,
no.
I better be going. I gotta find some cover quick.
Charlie, you idiot. Blow the fuse out. Pull it out there.
I can't do that, boss. The dynamite wouldn't blow up then. You better find some cover yourself.
But I can't get
out of here.
Wait a minute. Jailer, I want to go to the benefit. Let me out of here. I got to get out of here.
You can't get out of there, partner. I can't do
that.
What
do you mean? All the other prisoners are there, and if they can go, I can go. Get me out of here.
No, I'm afraid you can't go.
Why not?
Well, I lost the key to your cell door.
Oh, no. Well, there's got to be another one.
Well, there was, but don't you remember me telling you? I lost it when I first got this job.
Oh, no! No, this guy... Listen, you gotta get me out of... I gotta get out of here.
I know how you feel, Mr. Slocum. I'd be real disappointed, too, if I had to miss that show.
No.
I'll see you later.
Come back here. I gotta...
Wait a minute. I almost plumb forgot.
What?
You had a... That's what I was trying to remember. Here it is. It's a pardon come in the mail for you this morning.
Pardon?
Yeah.
Let me
out
of here.
I'll get to the show. I'll see you at the show.
Wait a minute. Let me out of here.
Who forged Slocum's pardon? Where did Sheriff Drywall lose the jail cell key? Just how much dynamite did Charlie set to go off? To find out, tune in next week.
Hey, Texas Bix.
What?
This is the epilogue.
So?
Well, you can't have a cliffhanger ending here. It's supposed to wrap it all up.
You're exactly right, Woody Paul.
Hey, what's wrong with a cliffhanger ending?
Have writers in the sky finally found peace in the valley? Is this the end of the evil Slocum? Will High Sheriff Drywall become a major recording artist in our lifetime? Tune in next week when you'll hear Too Slim say...
Ranger Doug, next Saturday, let's not play a benefit, okay?
And High Sheriff Drywall say...
Golly, somebody blowed my jail up. Who in the world's gonna pay for this? Sure ain't gonna be me, not on $2 a week.
All this and much more next week as we debut an exciting new Western melodrama, Mystery of the Lost Ozone. Don't miss it next week at this Theater of the Mind.